So 36 million healing done after 90 minutes in a solo steel path survival with Necros. 36 million, not exactly a small number. Now this is my Blood Altar Shield of Shadows Despoil Necros, which has a lot of different mods that bounce off one another to give him a steady supply of energy, of health, of armor, and of course damage reduction from having his shadows active. An hour and a half of a solo steel path survival is nothing to be sniffed at with any Warframe, let alone one that can give you heaps more resources. Now right now, Necros for me is easily one of the best Warframes in the game. Give him Pillage, give him Blood Altar, give him Petrify, give him whatever ability you want and just sit back and enjoy. And yes, this is my second Necros video in a week, but after the Petrify one, a lot of you commented and said to try out a Blood Altar Necros, so here he is, and this is how everything works together. Blood Altar on your Necros will work wonders at keeping his shadows and of course your teammates alive, and with his shadows alive, it means a constant damage reduction will stay active on your Necros. Now this whole build revolves around this set of mods. Health conversion for a bonus of 450 armor, which stacks up to 3 times for a total of 1350 armor. On your Necros, when you pick up health orbs, it will basically activate this. You'll see those little kind of cheese slices floating around my Necros. That's showing you how many of those are active at any given time. You want to try and keep 3 active at all times. Now, Equilibrium will give you health when you pick up energy and energy when you pick up health. Health orbs and energy orbs are candy with this setup for Necros. Health orbs especially will be dropping a lot of the time. Desecrate's Despoil Augment means that you will be draining health when you desecrate enemies' bodies instead of energy, which is perfect because you want to keep health conversion stacks active, you want to be able to keep picking up those health orbs, but you're also using Blood Altar for heals as well as a ton of health orbs spawning due to Synth Deconstruct on your Sentinel, or in my case, the Panzer Vulpophila instead. Now Shield of Shadows will share the damage that you take with your shadows that are linked to you, so 90% damage reduction will come with 214% power strength on your Necros. That's the limit, that's the kind of bar you need to set. The Shield of Shadows augment will allow you to share your damage taken from Necros with your shadows that are linked to you. You're going to need 214% power strength in order to hit the maximum of 90% damage reduction. Now for the pet mods, Synth Fiber and Synth Deconstruct, Deconstruct will spawn health orbs from enemies when your companion deals damage to them, which is all the bloody time if you're using the Panzer Vulpophila, which is the one that will spread those viral spores like Saren all around large groups of enemies. This means that you will be spawning a lot more health orbs, which will allow you to keep topping up your energy because you're using Equilibrium, or will allow you to keep stacking up those bonus armor from health conversion. Now, in relation to Synth Fiber and using it, yes, it will give your pet 100% bonus armor whenever you pick up a health orb. However, this mod allows you to pick up health orbs regardless of what Necros' current health values are. This means that, again, you can keep health conversion stacks active on Necros while running around picking up those health orbs regardless of what your health is, but also allows you to keep his energy full as well because you're using Equilibrium. Now I'm not running Flow or Prime Flow on this setup, so I have got quite a low energy pool and my energy was never once an issue throughout that whole 90 minute run. So having the combination of the Despoil, of Equilibrium, of Health Conversion, of the Synth Deconstruct all bouncing off one another means that Necros doesn't really have health or energy issues while also constantly stacking that bonus armor. Now for whatever melee weapon you want to run is entirely up to you. I did bring the combination of the Daikyu with the Amalgam mod on it and a Sepvan Nakana for constant heals and energy regen, because the one thing I noticed about this build is it's very heavily driven off momentum. If you die, which you tend to sometimes get one shot around the 1 hour mark, maybe 1 hour 20 minute mark, a random rocket could hit you and that is it, you're just done, especially if your shield is down, and getting your momentum back up for energy and all that when enemies are dealing that kind of damage can be quite hard. So I used the combination of the Sepvan Nakana and of course the Daikyu with the Amalgam mod to try and get fast energy regen, but truth be told, I didn't use heavy attacks really throughout this mission at all. I think I used it maybe 2 or 3 times at the very start of the run just to get my energy up, After that, I did not need it. So you could bring your most powerful melee weapon with Healing Return, that mod on it, to give you constant heals as well, and not be relying on the combination of the Daikyu and the Sephan. Now, I am also running Arcane Pulse and Arcane Guardian on this setup, which means I get another 900 bonus armor from Guardian, and Pulse will heal me, my Shadows, and my teammates whenever I pick up a health orb, but also Blood Altar is there, and I'm also using Healing Return on my melee weapon, so there is plenty of sources of healing coming into my Necros, which is why he's so hard to kill, while also having all of that bonus armor stacked, while also having the Shadows for 90% damage reduction, while also having Desecrate going for extra loot, for extra energy orbs, for extra health orbs, while also using Synth Deconstruct for extra health orbs as well. So there's a lot, right? This is a Warframe that can reduce armor with Terrify, can give himself 90% damage reduction, can heal constantly, can give extra resources, and is really, really hard to kill. But this is the build that I ran with on my Necros for that 90 minute run. Now, growing power would be the aura of choice for me in order to increase the effectiveness of the Blood Altar's heals, but you can use whatever aura you want. Brief Respite was what I actually used for this 90 minute run, but after running the 90 minutes, you find out pretty quickly that shields from Brief Respite don't really do a whole lot for you, and you would get much more benefit from additional heals from those altars, while also giving your Shadows additional heals as well. Health Conversion, Equilibrium, the Spoil, and Shield of Shadows for the reasons I've already explained. Blind Rage and Power Drift are the two mods you need in combination to get 214% power strength, which is needed for that 90% damage reduction. Streamline was to try and off balance the Blind Rage negativity you get from it, so that I could cast abilities. Since I'm not using Flow or Prime Flow, I have a much lower energy pool, which means having a terrible efficiency isn't exactly what you want. Now, Vitality is just for a higher health pool, but again, use whatever the hell mods you want. Melee Weapon, again, can be whatever you want. Once you're using Healing Return on it for whenever you're outside of the Blood Altar range, since it is the default size, I couldn't fit range mods onto my Necros unless maybe I drop maybe Streamline for stretch, or drop Vitality for a range mod, might be worth trying, I guess. So while my previous build showcasing Petrify on my Necros gave you much more resources in terms of double dipping, it definitely didn't give you the kind of survivability that this setup gives you, and all that's left for me now is to try and decide what Warframe should I try and show off next, and what kind of build. I am genuinely thinking about having a look at Hydroid, but I'm not sure what exactly you would put on Hydroid to make him finally shine. I'm gonna say finally shine, right? Finally shine. I don't know. I'll see. I'm gonna have to work over the next few days over a different Warframe. I don't want to keep using the same abilities on every bloody Warframe, so I'll see. But by all means, let me know in the comment section below what you think of the one man spectral army Necros, and as always, thanks very much for watching.